$30 well spent, yes. Goes off in my pocket for crying out. You know, this is fantastic, folks, having this many people in here. We are so happy, and I think we're going to put on a nice show for you. You're going to hear some great different styles of music, not necessarily just jazz, but you're going to hear some things from five or six different decades, and you're going to hear some fantastic vocalists. I'd just like to welcome everybody and thank you for attending the concert today. My name is Bob Holden, and I'm very proud to be the director of the Springfield Community Jazz Ensemble. This 20-member band has been in existence for 13 years and has performed numerous concerts throughout Springfield and the surrounding area. Today we're performing to honor a wonderful organization called Convoy of Hope, and you will learn a little more about that later in the concert. The band is very happy to have as our guests the three stars of the Branson show called The Magnificent Seven, and that is Tamra Holden Tinoco. Yes, Holden Tinoco, my daughter. Okay. Tamra and her husband Joe Tinoco and their daughter Talya. The Tinoco family has performed with many outstanding entertainers over the years in Branson, Nashville, and around the United States, including a season with their own show on the Disney Magic cruise ship. That was the first Disney ship, and they had their own show on that. It was a very interesting experience. Tamra, a former member of Wesley Methodist Church here, and actually grew up in this church, and her first singing experiences were in this church, singing at sometimes with her younger brother, who happens to be in attendance tonight. He surprised us. So he's here with his family, but they sang in church, and that was the beginning of her career, I guess. Has a very impressive resume with many performances with Lee Greenwood, the Osmond Brothers, Jim Stafford, and Tony Orlando, and just to name a few. And she also has served as Miss Springfield and was a recipient of the Outstanding Female Vocalist Award in Branson. So that's Tamra, and you're going to hear her a little later. Joe, her husband, is from Olathe, Kansas, has had opportunities to perform with numerous country artists in Nashville, Kansas City, and Branson, including Clint Black, Ferlin Husky, Freddie Fender, Ray Price, and Lori Morgan. He also has performed on the Grand Ole Opry and at the Ryman Auditorium Theater in Nashville, and has appeared in movies with Dolly Parton and Paul Newman. Ah, okay. Makes you look at him a little differently, doesn't it? Their daughter, Talya, started performing at the age of 3 on her parents' Branson show, Magnificent Seven, and has never lost a desire for performing on stage, which includes vocally, dance-wise, and acting. She recently appeared in The Sound of Music and Something's Rotten at the Branson Community Theater and the Drowsy Chaperone and 42nd Street at Branson High School. She is a senior this year. The musical selections and featured solos will be shown on the video screen so you can see like you did. Blue Bossa was our first song, so you saw that's what it is. Each of our songs we do, I don't have to talk about them, and I'm just so happy about that. So. Just look at the screen and you'll see who's going to be performing and who is playing solos, like Jim Shannon did on that last one. And I just hope you will enjoy our presentation today. Thank you for being here.
Hello, everybody. Well, I tried to get Bob to do a good old country classic from Hank Williams, but he said this band didn't play that music, so. So here we go, here's a little something. I broke out my jazz tie for this event. I've never worn this thing before, so it's the first time. feel free to sing along.
To the moon, and let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss me. Fill my heart with song.
Beautiful half up here. This is my lovely wife, Tamra, for those of you that don't know, most of you know. Here's a classic by Nat King Cole.
Thank you.
I Somewhere.
Sitting right over there, so wow. Okay, we're going to take just a little bit of a break from the music, and if I can find my notes. Okay, I found it. At this time, we would like to show a short video on the screens up here about Convoy of Hope and some of the work that they do. If you would please look at the screens on each side of the stage and right in the middle here.
You know, this has been a trip of stark contrast. The excitement of products and supplies being loaded on trucks and shipped directly into Ukraine, where it is distributed in unmarked vans to every part of the country. The complicated process of international shipments arriving in wave after wave to multiple countries surrounding Ukraine, bringing more food, medicines, and everyday necessities to where they are needed most. The joy of seeing in Lviv, Ukraine, with our own eyes, churches packed the morning after the city was bombed, and the city itself bustling with both faith in God and defiance to the aggressors. Then seemingly minutes later, the air raid siren sounding, sending people to bomb shelters again. And there's one more giant contrast this week. This is the crematorium of a former Nazi concentration camp, and all that brings to mind. But literally, right across the street is the Convoy of Hope warehouse, where hope and a whole lot of help is being delivered directly into Ukraine. Thanks for your help. Together, in the name of Jesus, we are taking hope to where it needs to be.
Okay, Convoy of Hope has served over 200 million people and is currently feeding nearly 465,000 children in 29 nations each school day. That's just overwhelming to me. For 27 years, Convoy has worked with churches, businesses, government agencies, and other nonprofits to provide help and hope to those in need. Convoy has received Charity Navigator's highest four-star rating for 19 consecutive years and consistently receives national attention for its tireless response to national disasters. I had the privilege of going over to their headquarters here right outside Springfield over near Republic, and some of the folks here from Wesley went with us. And I could not believe what I saw. The huge amount of food, the huge amount of supplies right here. And at the same time as I was looking at that, they said there are 22 places in the world that they are giving food to and equipment and all kinds of things. I just couldn't believe it was is that huge. So at this time, I really want to give the audience an opportunity to give a love offering to Convoy. And I will say this, if you are going to write a check, please make it out to Wesley United Methodist Church and put in the memo line underneath Convoy of Hope. And as we're getting ready to do that, the band is going to play something for you, so you'll have something to do besides give money. You're going to hear a really interesting piece of music. If you like 70s and 80s rock, Motown, things like that, we've got an arrangement that has three songs in it that are just really fun, and I'll bet you that you know this, just about everybody in here will know the names of those songs. There will be a test afterwards. Okay, so we'll do that, and if we would have the ushers, the welcoming people from the church here, will be taking any contributions that you would like to give, and we would appreciate it very much. Thank you. see, a jazz man can play all kinds of music. And that's a form of jazz, you know. That was all of these different rock things that come about really stole a lot of things from jazz way back. And so we can play rock and roll, we could play country, but we don't have a steel guitar. So we really don't go into that. But if you want to hear it sometime, I don't know, Joe, where are you performing next? You don't know, okay. He is a fantastic country singer. I mean, really good. So one of these days, maybe he'll do a country concert somewhere we can get you. All right. Thank you for your love offering, and appreciate it. I know Convoy and Wesley Methodist appreciates it very much. I think now we're just going to take about 15 minutes and give this band a chance to catch their breath, and we'll come back and you're going to get to hear Tamra.